Coming up on CTV News, hear what students have to say about the recent development in the new on-campus stadium.
And if you're a Summit resident frustrated with limited parking, a new solution may make the space more convenient.
All this and more on tonight's episode of CTV.
Good evening, Rams, and welcome back to school. I'm Kay Bennett.
And I'm Brain Carmen. CSU has received approval for the $22 million in revenue bonds for the construction of the new on-campus stadium. With this news, CSU students voiced their opinions on the price tag, the construction, and saying goodbye to Hughes Stadium. Growing up in the area, CSU senior Reginald Johnston is an avid CSU football fan.
Actually, a local, I'm from Fort Collins, so I've gone to Hughes Stadium like since I was a little kid watching football games. So.
Johnston is a big fan of Hughes and voiced his concerns about the new stadium.
The location of it and how it's like set up is just like, I don't know, I think it's a lot cooler than like having a stadium here on campus that's just gonna like totally congest Fort Collins if during game days, you know, so.
Eric Lindquist loves Hughes where it is and isn't looking forward to more campus renovations.
But I think it's fine where it is. I mean, campus, I kind of hate all the construction that already happens here anyway.
Geneva McCarthy, a junior, is a little more optimistic about the stadium approval and the positives it can bring.
More of a draw, they'll get better crowds and more student participation.
Although some students have their reservations about the stadium approval, Johnston thinks it will be good for the next generation of future Rams.
That are maybe like newcomers might think it's a good idea just because like the hype of it, you know, and like everyone thinking that it is going to bring like more attractions and stuff.
Groundbreaking for the stadium is set for summer of 2015, but an official date has not yet been announced.
Students living in the Summit apartment complex have made complaints to the city about limited parking. I spoke with residents to hear what they had to say.
The parking garage at the Summit on College has been approved by the City Council. I spoke with Summit residents to see how they felt about the garage.
Definitely when you put a parking garage in, you know, and people stop having to park across the street, it's going to be a lot more convenient, so it's going to improve the Summit.
I think it'd be, you know, really beneficial to the students to have a parking garage, because then it'd be more parking, you know, and then more revenue for Summit, I guess.
I know that someone always parks in my spot almost once a week, and I always have to tow them, and I feel really bad because it's expensive.
Although the Summit does have off-site parking designated for residents, many students choose to park across the street at College and Parker, which involves jaywalking across the busy intersection. This is not only dangerous for Summit residents, but it also caused parking congestion in those nearby neighborhoods.
And it's packed over there, like cars on cars. There's no room for anyone over there.
All of the students I interviewed agreed.
The parking garage is a necessary solution to the serious lack of parking spaces for residents at the Summit. So, as long as the company working on the project, the Capstone Development Corporation, meets the City Council's requirements, they are all set to begin building this summer. Kay Bennett, CTV News.
Well, make sure to check collegian.com for more updates on the project as soon as construction begins.
And speaking of Fort Collins construction, the popular grocery store chain Trader Joe's is nearly finished. The grand opening is just a month away on February 27th at 8 a.m. This will be in south of College. Trader Joe's is known for having a more unique selection of environmentally friendly products.
The LSC has finally reopened, as you know, and this week during the Lori Student Appreciation Celebration, CSU is adding one more final touch, students and faculty.
Since 2013, the Lori Student Center has been under reconstruction. $70 million later, the LSC reopens its doors, excited to celebrate this revitalization.
Good thing to do it for CSU to showcase this thing. And it shows that this university is at the cutting edge and constantly striving to do better.
I have the time I like to come in and explore and like find all the different aesthetic things that they've added.
Juan Su, marketing coordinator with CSU, encourages students to attend events held throughout the week in light of LSC appreciation.
We're appreciating the student, faculty, staff, and the constituents for all of this that's going on. For the construction, there was a lot of stuff going on. It took about three years to actually complete this. We tried to go with the new feel, eat, play, shop, relax, gather, learn. This is what you can do at the Lori Student Center. Your home away from home is also another part of our Lowry Student Center theme.
And they used basically the same floor plan, they just expanded it a little bit. But they made it more efficient, so that's good.
Along with food, entertainment, and giveaways, the LSC shows appreciation for patient students and faculty who can now utilize the renovated facility. Callie Vara, CTV News.
For more information on this week's LSC appreciation activities, visit collegian.com.
On Monday, several students gathered in the LSC for Roommate Roundup. The event is put on by Off Campus Live and is an easy way for students to meet people in a safe environment. Their goal is to provide a place to meet prospective roommates that they are CSU students that you can meet face-to-face instead of online. Off Campus Life will be hosting more roommate roundups as well as other classes and workshops for living in Fort Collins later this year. For more information about future events, visit www.ocl.colostate.edu.
Fiberlock, a Fort-based company, will be putting its stamp on the Super Bowl this year. For 35 years, Fiberlock has been making merchandise for the NFL. But this Sunday, they will be making logos from everything from what goes on t-shirts to end zone pylons. The company predicts that it will make at least 250,000 logos for this year's game.
And coming up after the break, join us to hear Rachel Vigil's recap of CSU sports.
And after that, we'll check in with Austin Harley in the Weather Center. Stay tuned.
It's cold outside today, Rams. What better way to warm up than to gather in the LSC? The new and improved Senate chambers located in the renovated ASCSU office was modeled to match the state legislature in Denver. Reserve the Long's Peak meeting room in room 302. There are approximately 23 other new meeting rooms designed for your needs. Reserve one of these rooms through the event planning office. Today is a great day to play in the LSC, so let's take a look at our ballrooms, theater, and art galleries. The LSC ballrooms, which are the busiest venue in northern Colorado, have been recently renovated. The Lowry Student Center Theater can be transformed to feature films, concerts, lectures, entertainment, and banquets. And last but not least, the Kerfman Gallery provides a showcase for the creations of local and student artists.
We now join Rachel Vigil in the Sports Center. It's been a busy week in sports. What do you have for us tonight, Rachel?
Well, Rams, I'm guessing that if you're watching this, you aren't at the women's basketball game against Boise State. The Rams are currently losing with a score of 46-52 right after the half. The Rams are hoping to win tonight after losing to Boise State in the conference opener. After being moved to number 24 in the USA coaches poll, the men's basketball team suffered a heartbreaking loss 82-78 to Boise State on Tuesday night. Daniel Bejarano led the team with 19 points, followed by Joe Desiman with 15 points. JJ Avila led the team with 9 rebounds and was also named Mountain West Player of the Week after his performance against San Diego State. CSU takes on Fresno State at Moby Arena on Saturday. Tip-off is set for 4 p.m. Running back Dee Hart and linebacker Aaron Davis were officially added to the NFL Combine in February. Kicker Jared Roberts was also invited and went to Twitter earlier today saying, "Just accepted an invite to the NFL Combine. Extremely grateful for this opportunity. Can't wait to get out to Indy." Quarterback Grant Grayson and offensive lineman Ty Sambarillo had previously been invited. Five representative from CSU is the most the Combine had seen since 1999. Well, Rams, that's all the news I have for you. Back to the newsroom.
Thanks, Rachel. Now, this weather has been absolutely beautiful, Kay. These temps have been record-breaking for January, and I have no complaints.
Brian, I don't either. This weather has been fantastic. It's reminding me of my home back in San Diego, actually.
Yeah.
It's wonderful. Well, Austin Harley's in the Weather Center now to tell us if these temps are here to stay. Austin?
Kay and Bryn, I mean, it has been absolutely so nice over the last few days. I cannot even believe it myself. That record-breaking high we set on Monday at 73 degrees was the record for the entire month of January in Fort Collins, and that's helped to melt some of the ice that one of our viewers set in today from Fossil Creek Park. This is our friend RJ Jensen. He was down south end of Fort Collins today and took this picture for us, so thanks for that. Here's what we're looking at right now outside of our studio. The winds have died down a bit. You may remember this afternoon, we were gusting up to 20 to 25 miles an hour. A little inconvenient, but You can see that flag right there has calmed down. And a couple people out and about tonight, just grab a jacket or a sweatshirt on your way out the door. Here's temperatures right now. We're sitting in the 40s, 42 degrees, partly cloudy skies this evening here at just after 8 o'clock. That wind still going a little bit. You might not have seen it in that flag. It's kind of come and go now, but 36 degree wind chill when we do have that wind rolling through. Here's what you can expect for the rest of the evening if you have plans to go out at any time. 42, mostly cloudy now. We'll go full clouds throughout the rest of the night and drop into the 30s by midnight. That's thanks to a weak system that may just bring a few flurries to the high country overnight. We'll stay dry here, just a little bit of cloud cover. And coming after the break, I'll tell you a little more about what to expect tomorrow and for the rest of the week. Kay and Bryn, back to you.
Thanks. After the break, we'll hear more from Austin so you can plan accordingly for these next few weeks. Don't go away.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
The next 30 seconds can save you a lot of money. Just do your laundry in cold and stick to full loads. Auto-sleep your computers. Plug your gadgets in a power strip and switch it off when you're done. Head it out, turn back your thermostat by 10 degrees. And drive sensibly. The more energy you save, the more money you save. Find other great tips at energysaver.gov.
Welcome back from the break. A beautiful day again today. That wind did bring temperatures a little cooler, but we still reached the mid-60s this afternoon. And you can see now the winds have died down this evening, and that should make for a fairly pleasant evening tonight. More mild for typically our winter evenings. Tomorrow, we will be having a cold front moving through this evening, so that means we're going back to more normal temperatures for this time of year. We're headed to 46 degrees tomorrow afternoon. You can notice decreasing clouds. Like I spoke about before the break, we'll have a weak system bring some flurries to the mountains tonight. We'll stay dry down here, and then we'll slowly burn off that cloud cover through the day tomorrow, and by the evening, 38 degrees at 6 p.m. and mostly clear skies. Here's what you can expect to wear as you head out the door tomorrow. Just bring a sweatshirt along, really. There's no chance of precipitation, and it's not going to be too awful cold for us Coloradoans, so just a sweatshirt will do you for the day tomorrow. Here's what our satellite graphic looks like. That cold front is outlined in blue right here. That's a mass of cold air moving south into our area, and that's what will help to bring those temperatures down from those beautiful 60s and 70s we had back towards the normal for this time of year, those 40s. Look off here, southwest of California. That's a low pressure system, and that's making its way slowly towards Colorado. It will speed up a little bit as it reaches here, but that's what's going to be happening on Saturday. So look at this. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, mostly cloudy, 44. We'll go a little more mild for your Friday, mostly cloudy conditions then, and that's going to be another day of increasing clouds. So sunny in the morning. We'll build up clouds quite a bit by the evening, and that's ahead of this next system that will arrive very early on Saturday morning and persist throughout the day on Saturday. Earlier this week, models were showing maybe a several inches of snow, and I was keeping a close eye on it. But as we've moved farther on in the week, it's trended downward, and we're looking maybe now an inch or less for your Saturday. So nothing too impactful to your plans. It will be cold, though, this weekend as we move towards the low to upper 30s for most of the day on Sunday, partly cloudy. Then we clear out, warm up, and dry out a little bit for Monday. Mid-50s make a return, so pretty good weather on the way for the rest of the next five days. So beautiful conditions. Maybe don't plan something for the weekend, but plan some for the weekdays. It's all up to you. Back to you, Kay and Bryn.
Thanks for watching CTV News this evening. Be sure and watch all of our shows live Monday through Thursday at 8 o'clock.
That's right. And if you happen to miss any shows, you can, of course, watch them online at thecollegian.com or on our brand new app, which we're really excited about. Have a great night, everyone. Enjoy your Super Bowl weekend, and we'll see you next time.
Good night.